Hi, welcome to Some Answered Questions today. So I'm often asked what my routines are, what do I do? You know, I've been doing this for 50 years now, and my process didn't come about overnight, which is why I'm always a little bit hesitant to share too much, because I want everyone to be so comfortable in their own process. But what I can tell you kind of changed it all for me, kind of set me apart from the way the rest of the world was going for so long, is because I never forgot, no matter what stage of the journey I was in, to cleanse and detox my body. Now, I know it's a buzzword now. Everybody talks about cleansing and detoxing. When I started this 50 years ago, when you cleanse or detox, that meant you were cleansing from alcohol or drugs, you know. But now everybody's aware of the green drinks and the fasting and the cleansing. And it is a buzzword. And I think it's the most important thing that I teach and that I do and that I live on a consistent basis. Because yes, I'm vegan for 50 years, no meat, fish, chicken, or dairy. Yes, I'm raw foodist, getting close to 40 years now. I don't drink, smoke, or do drugs. I pray and meditate every day. But I really consider the single most important thing I do is to cleanse and detox my body. Why? Because we are a part of this world. No matter how clean or how perfectly you try to live, you're breathing this air. You know, we're not in 38% oxygen levels anymore. You may be buying organic like me, although this year I'm doing a farm, my own little farm. But even though you're buying organic, the organic farm is right next to the pig farm, or just down the road from it. So, you know, the wind doesn't say stop here and the chemicals don't go. We are living in such a chemicalized world these days that, you know, unless you're in the jungle, in the rainforest somewhere, I don't know how you could escape it. You know, I mean, you can do the best that you can, which we all do, those of us on this path. But what do I do to ensure that my brain doesn't get caught up? Because, you know, we're symbiotically connected to each other. There's a negative gravitational pull to go in the other direction. And how do I keep myself, my energy, my vibration from falling into that? Well, once again, it's the cleansing and detoxing. There are many roads to the top of the mountain, and I don't believe my way is the only way. But I do know that I have been doing this for 50 years, and I'm very comfortable with what I teach and what I've been doing. I do not believe in, you know, eating your cooked food or whatever you're doing, or a steak or whatever, one day and then the next day you go on a 3-day juice fast. I actually think that's dangerous. It's kind of like the body doesn't really know what's going on. I know a lot of the people are preaching the intermittent fasting, and it's basically just eating less, and I really agree with that. But, you know, calling it fasting, I mean, having such a, I don't know, that doesn't resonate with me as much as taking what I call sacred healing time. 4 times a year, and the older I get, you guys know I turn 72 this April 20th. The older I get, the more I feel I need to detox, because my organs, I'm just exposed to life, you know, and even if I'm eating as close to perfectly as I know, I'm still taking in negative energy. It's just part of the world that we live in today, and it's part of the university of life. We need to kind of overcome, not sit behind it, but overcome and stay with whatever intention you have decided is your next journey. And you may not even know what your next journey is, but you see, what I find is when you cleanse and detox, you figure it out. That inner self tells you this is what you're supposed to be doing. So, to that end, I do teach detox classes. Like I said, I've been doing them for 50 years, and I'm very comfortable in the process that I teach. I've taken from Dr. Wigmore and Victoria Skolvenskas, who were my mentors and teachers, and I've kind of incorporated some of the stuff that I learned being in Asia and Hong Kong on a consistent basis for a while, and I've just kind of incorporated everything. And I think I found a very pleasant way, because basically what you're doing is just taking yourself to your next step. You aren't necessarily going to live as a raw foodist after your first one, or even a vegan or a vegetarian, but the body cleans out enough to figure out where it's ready to go. We have an innate wisdom. It's called guts. Your guts, you know. It's called instincts. You know what you're supposed to be doing. You've just forgotten. And I found, for me, that cleansing and detoxing my body, not little 2-3 day things, but real cleansing and detoxing, gets me closer and closer to my core over the years. So I'm going to be offering some classes as usual, but now we stream them all over the world, which is very cool. So those of you not in the Chicago area can come to our classes. I will be doing more retreats where we will be doing, you know, I just finished one with my dear friend Victoria Skolvenskas and Johnny Juicer in Costa Rica. I will have one up and coming soon, another one soon. And it's just to me, it's about taking that sacred time to pull yourself away from what you're doing on a consistent basis and see where your body is ready to go next. So to have an intention is exciting, and you may not stick to that intention, but you're planting the seeds to come forward later. And this is what I'm all about. I'm not about a right or a wrong or a good or a bad or a yes or a no or my way or the highway or this is going to happen or, you know, oh, I recently did one on fruit and boy, did I catch my lunch on that with a couple of people. But I'm not telling you to do anything. I'm offering you seeds of what has worked for me for 50 years. And, you know, if you've got somebody out there that's resonating with you and this is what they say to do and it feels right, hey, go for it. But what I'm saying is clean out and find out so you know what's right for you, not what I'm saying is right for you, not what so-and-so says this grams of that and do this and do that. You know. So I offer detox classes to help you, or you may find somebody else that resonates with you. I just want the world to be filled with more awake people, more like-minded people and awake. Not all alike. I don't want us all to be alike, but like-minded people that so we can grow and prosper this whole journey that we're all on to save the planet, save ourselves, and do better. So I got some writing here. I have a 10-day quick reboot. Often people DM me saying, I'm trying to be vegan or I'd like to change my diet. What do you suggest? Well, my quick reboot is a very easy one to do because it doesn't require tons. You're kind of, I give you guidelines, I give you direction, but you kind of take it to where you're going. And it's easier to commit to 10 days as opposed to the 30-day one that I taught for the past 40 years. So I came up with what I call Karen's Quick Reboot. It's a 10-day reboot. It's ideal class for those detoxing for the first time or who've fallen off the wagon or who just maybe it's the next step in your journey before you do my 30-day, you know, because a lot of people do the 10-day and then they do the 30-day right afterwards. But I do have the 10-day reboot coming up. It will be May 13th. Will be the first class, then May 20th, and then the last class is on the 24th. So it's a commitment, it's an easy commitment, and you do the best that you can. What can you expect? I can make you a guarantee that you will feel and look differently. How do I know? Because it's not my program. It's kind of like God's, you know, we kind of download what to do. Then after that, I have a 28-day detox class coming up, and that one starts June 3rd. And it's a 4-week detox class, and it's a little more involved. I do have products that I recommend. I have my own line of products, but you don't have to use my products. If you have some of these at home already, I'm just going to help you get re-inspired or use them for the first time. It's kind of nice to put yourself in a position where you kind of have to do the best that you can because life just comes at you from every direction. So if you make a commitment and you have an intention, it's a little bit easier to stick to it if you know you're going to be done over here. And we have you're able to work with other people doing it. So I have the, they're calling it the 28-day detox. I guess that would be me they're calling it. And that's coming up in June. So you have two ways to jump in and detox with me. Or you know what? And we will be streaming it. And with the streaming, there will be video on demand. So if you can't be there in that moment when we're filming the class, you can pull it up later for a few weeks. And you can even have some other people come in and do it, bootleg it. You know, get a whole group and do it together. I really recommend doing that. The more people doing it with you, the easier it can be because of that symbiotic energy once again. So, hey, come join me. And by the way, in the in-between, direct message me your questions to my Instagram or send them to me at YouTube. I'm just learning to be at the YouTube channel a little bit better to answering your questions because I'm really getting into this now. I'm taking this 72-year-old thought process back to where so many of you guys are. So anyway, I really look forward to learning more about you and your needs, giving you more of what I've learned and done over the years. And I really hope that whether you detox with me or not, you find a sensible way to do it, because it shouldn't be either or, that you don't just drop off all of a sudden. With my program, we gradually get there. We do things to balance blood sugar levels, shrink the tummy, all kinds of great things. And we have some wonderful results over the years. So I really hope you join me, and I'd like for you to remember that if you don't take care of this, your body, the most magnificent machine you'll ever be given, where are you going to live? Bye.